This is Tom with your fishing report from the Northeast. Winter fishing in this part of the state usually boils down to just a few locations. The first of these is the Ohio River, where sauger can be caught behind the dams and crappie can be caught in some of the backwaters. Baits to use with the sauger are vibrating medium running crankbaits, super dupers or white curly tailed grubs, and jigs and minnows are good for the crappie. The second location to try out would be Greenbelt and Mill Creek Lake, which are stocked in the early part of the year. The tailwaters of Cave Run Lake can be great this time of the year if the water is right. Out there you have a chance at walleye, sauger, crappie, muskie, white bass, and about any of the black bass. Right now there's a great chance for a muskie, both at the tailwaters and points further downstream. But wherever you go, good luck and stay safe.
Hi, this is Kevin Pry with your Eastern Area Fisheries Report. Recently, lakes were opened up some from ice cover and producing good crappie fishing at Fish Trap and Dewey Lakes. Keeper fish are coming out of deadfall trees near shoreline. Most fishing is occurring in lower end of lakes where there was less ice. This week, rainbow trout were stocked in Paintsville Lake, Kingdom Come Lake, and in Martin County Water Plant Reservoir, and in Martin County Lake at Milo. Some ice cover may delay fishing for these trout. However, if warmer weather prevails, look for some good trout fishing at these locations.
Hi, this is Eric Cummins with your Southwestern Kentucky Fishing Report. At Barron and Green River Lakes, crappie activity has been fair to good with minnows or minnow and jig combos around brush or stump beds in 5 to 10 foot of water in stained areas and 10 to 20 foot of water in clear areas. Bass have been fair at both lakes with suspended jerk baits or blade baits like silver buddies or cicadas, and jig fishing is also producing some fish. Muskie fishing at Green River Lake has been good. Fish are up shallow in the colored water and fair on lipless crankbaits and jerkbaits. Trout fishing opportunities are good throughout the Cumberland tailwater. Fagan Branch Lake near Lebanon was stocked with trout this past week. And then also Three Springs Lake at Basil Griffin Park and Bowling Green will be stocked next week. As always, good luck and good fishing. Be sure to wear your life jacket.
We're at Lake Barkley. It's so well managed. It's such a great, huge body of water right next to Kentucky Lake. Every time I've come down, regardless what time of year, we catch fish, and I love it. Normally, Jim Doom, we go fishing with him.
Ready to load up.
He's a professional guide and one of the best I know. But today, he's going with us. He gets to fish. He doesn't have to worry about baiting anybody's hooks.
Tell us what season it is down here at Barkley.
Bluegill season, red ear season.
Looks like there'd be fish right there, doesn't it?
Very well, could be. Best tackle box ever made. I got him.
Presentation is basically just trying to drag us across the nest, aggravate somebody enough to want to come up and bite it, running the bobber, watching the bobber. There he is. Oh, man. Let me tell you what, he got off, but that was not a little fish. What are you throwing at him, Jim? Black grub, you putting anything on it?
A little bit of worm.
A little bit of worm?
Just a horse pasture worm. It's a blue herring.
Oh, I'm missing them. He got my worm too. Now that's not nice.
You know, watching that bobber go under just brings the kid out of you.
Oh yeah. You know what? Oh, you had a bass. I don't know. I have never graduated past the point where I didn't like bluegill fishing. That's where I started out. Oh, he'll eat. He will eat. There we go.
Clean him up here. Those are really pretty fish. Notice too, a lot of times you catch several bluegill and then you'll catch a red ear or two out.
Uh-huh. There he is. Come on now.
Got him.
Okay.
That.
You got a little bigger fish.
Could be a red ear right there.
Unless you got that bass again.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, it's a big red ear.
Where's the dip
net? It's a big red ear. We don't have a net.
Don't have a scooper?
Don't have a scooper. I just now thought of that. You're going to have to.
Can
we lip him? Can we grab him? We don't want to lose that
fish. No, we don't want to lose this fish.
Gee, that fish is turning some water.
Look at that.
You gotta be kidding. Help cut that fish a liar. Look at that. Jim, jeez. Have you caught any like that this year?
No, that's about the biggest this year so far.
Oh,
but
my.
This is the only second time we've been.
So, oh, yeah. My. Look, you have that. Got to be kidding me. Look at that. I mean, what's the limit on those?
15 red ear per day per person. No size limit.
When they're hot like that and protect their nest, you could throw just about anything at them.
What is your favorite fish to eat?
You can't hardly beat bluegill and, you know, just cornmeal and a little salt and pepper. It's a bonus type situation. If you like to catch bluegill, then you're not going to hate catching a 2-pound shell cracker. All right, I got something here, boys. I'm not sure what
that's
it is.
That's a red ear. Betcha.
All right.
Got to be.
Sure pulling like it. Oh, it is. It is.
Look at him.
Jim, help me get
golly.
This fish in here. Oh, my goodness.
Golly. That's bigger
oh,
than the first one.
Oh, my goodness, Jim. That's the biggest red ear I've ever caught, if I catch him.
Oh, we're going to catch him.
Oh, my goodness. You got him, Jim.
He's in the boat.
That is the biggest red ear I've ever caught in my life. And, good Jim, gosh. I will have that fish mounted, or a replica maybe.
Here you go.
Oh,
you know
goodness.
They're big when you can lip them.
Oh my goodness. That is the biggest red ear I've ever caught in my life.
Jeez.
That's not right, Jim. That's Barkley Lake in the springtime. I gotta sit down. I might throw up. I want you to look at that. That is the most, that's the biggest red ear I've ever caught.
That one's getting better.
Well, I tell you what, fishing is good on these lakes. First, because you just have the climate, you have the right temperature, you have the right growing season. But more than that, you have good fisheries management.
Everyone that I've ever met and dealt with fishing wildlife really enjoy their job. To me, that's what it takes to someone to enjoy their job to make it work.
Oh, look at here. No, it's a big bluegill. Well, how about that? You don't hear too many people complaining about fishing and hunting in Kentucky. Oh my goodness, Jim. Jim, we got something going on here.
He's gonna do it. He's got another one.
Oh, Jim, I got another hog. I've got another hog. I'm gonna get him in the boat. Oh my goodness. Look at that. Jimbo. That's not right. Those daggone red ear, you feel a thump, don't you, Jim? You just feel them cut. They got that big, broad body, and they start cutting that water and throwing that head. And then you know there's a little different thing going on than a bluegill.
You're going to be challenged with 6-pound line
oh, yeah.
with those, because they fight like crazy. They're strong fish.
This has been an unreal experience. And I mean, what have we been here, Jim, an hour?
Yeah, about that.
But we got a taste of what it can be like down here. Got plenty of bluegill for fish fry. And some dinner plate sized. Oh, just unbelievable. Look at that. Look at that. Thank you so much, man. I had a lot of fun. And oh, I can't hardly talk. We're blessed to have such a wonderful fishery. Everybody's coming to Kentucky.